allow me to reintroduce myself. The name's Queen.
Hey guys, how's everybody doing? And welcome to 2021. Yes. First video of 2021, guys, and whew, we made it. Hunger Games part one is over, and let's hope that there will not be a sequel in 2021. Like, I'm really happy, really glad to have made it to another year, and just thankful, you know, thankful to God for his blessings, for his provisions, for his safety, for seeing me through. Like, literally made it out of 2020 alive, and that in itself is a blessing. So gratitude is definitely a must. And yeah, I'm just, as you can see, today's location or video is slightly different because I have company, and even though they do watch my videos, I'm still not there with filming in front of them. So I'm just gonna kick it in here and just, I guess, start off 2021 with some good vibes and all that good stuff. I just wanted to recap on 2020, the year that was. To be honest, I've been seeing so many posts that say, oh, you know, like, obviously people being thankful that they made it through and emphasizing how shitty 2021 was. And yes, guys, we know it was pretty shitty. We were there. But I don't know, I feel like because I've heard it throughout the whole year that, oh my gosh, you know, 2020 is really crazy. I'm kind of over it, so let's move on. And let's hope for the best. Like, 2021, please, please be good to us, please. So yeah, that's where we're here today. And I also wanted to recap some of my highlights. I think 2019 had a lot more in terms of like big moments for me than 2020 did, but it also just came with its own blessings. And even in that, I'm super thankful, you know, for some of the things that happened throughout the year. So let's kind of recap the year that was. At the beginning of 2020, I don't know if you guys have seen my vision board video where I attended a vision board party hosted by the lovely Taonga. Taonga girl. Yeah, so she hosted, Taonga hosted a vision board party that I attended, and it was so amazing, and we got to like put our hopes and dreams down and things like that and interact, and it was super fun. So it was the third time, I think. Yeah. So I've been doing vision boards for quite a while now, and I haven't yet done my 2021 board. I still have to find time to do it, but I feel like I need to recap kind of the 2021, just so that we can see what we aced and maybe what we can work harder on and what we can carry over into the new year. So let's do that. What are some of you guys' New Year's resolutions? Like, leave them in the comments below. I actually don't have any. Except to survive. Guys, okay. So this was my... I'm gonna put it. And don't laugh at my tummy fat, guys. I've gained a few pounds, kilos over the past festive season because it grows and leaves. So yeah, we're gonna start with mental health. Mental health. I really wanted to focus on like mind over matter in 2020, like to just center myself, to find balance in me and my thought process, stop panicking, stop trying to be such a with everything. And I wanted to take up yoga, and I did like a 30-day yoga challenge that I didn't complete. Okay. Yes. So I think, yes, let that be my New Year's resolution, guys. Like, I need to get serious on my fitness journey in 2021. I know I always say that, but this year is for real, for real. I actually did. I started going running and whatnot, and then, like, I got chased one time, and I just didn't feel safe after that, so I quit. But it's also kind of like an excuse for me to not really go back and do it. But anyway, that's another story for another day. So, yeah, fitness, I didn't really do that, so next year is coming with me. Spirit and well-being, which definitely I did get more in touch on with my spiritual side and my prayer life, my spiritual life. Even though I didn't physically attend church, I found myself attending online sermons more frequently than I was doing actually attending church in the year before. So, you know, like, everybody is doing online sermons, and I would watch like 3 in a week, sometimes even more, and just feeding my spirit and feeding my soul, and yes, discovering God in a whole different way, and it was amazing. And if anything, He will always take first priority, because to be honest, I'm nothing without Him. So amen to that. Nights out, we couldn't exactly go out. I mean, like, I didn't really go out in 2019 because I just was not, it was pretty depressing for me. So I didn't really go out much or hang out much, but I wanted to make a point that in 2020 I would make more time for my friends, for my family, and also just for myself, like going out and enjoying, celebrating life. I didn't do as much, obviously, because again, COVID and places were closed. But I tried to have more of a social life in 2020, which was good. It was good. Hello, sunshine. I wanted to travel a little bit more in 2020, but I didn't. Because, obviously, COVID, yay! So, I couldn't move or anything like that. So, I didn't go anywhere, actually, the whole year. But each year, 2021, I receive airplane tickets. I receive destination holidays, beaches, and warm weather and shit. Okay. So, and I have a quote here that says, the authenticity of your story is what gives you your power. No one can question your truth and your journey. This year, to be honest, I found power. Definitely. I found power and freedom in owning my story. Who I am. How I came to be, how I, you know, began my business, what led me to starting my business, discovering my passion and things like that. And I never really wanted to I wanted to always separate myself from my story, like who I am from what I do. But in 2020, I discovered that that is what makes me me, that is my superpower. And embracing who you are, where you come from, what made you you, and how you got to be, it all leads up to where you are now, and it makes you who you are. You can't leave out certain things of, you can't leave out certain parts of your story. I mean, if you want to, you can, but at the end of the day, every single thing that has happened to us, good or bad, has led us to this moment, led us here, and has by some way or another influenced or affected the way that we relate today in this moment. So I own my story, I shared my story, and it was so liberating. It was freeing, you know, because we hold on to the stuff, and sometimes just opening up and sharing with people who actually want to hear, it's good. Because then it makes other people want to share their stories. And I love that. I love that. So the next thing is power, women on top, success, queen bee, honey. If anybody wants to come at me and say that Bonang is, she's pretentious and she lives a false life or whatever, I will fight you. I'll fight you. Because she's just phenomenal. Bonang is phenomenal. The way she works and whoever is around her team that's made her is just amazing. And I feel like she's a hustler. She's a strong powerhouse. She's a beast. And she knows what she wants. She knows how to get it. And she goes after it. So in this year that's coming, guys, if there's anything that you want to chase after, the best, go after it. Okay? No excuses. So yeah, I did. Like, my business grew this year, which is fantastic. Thanks, guys. My business grew. I really wanted to be, I didn't want to just be a baker and, you know, like, that shouldn't be my only title. I wanted to kind of separate my business from my journey, which is my entrepreneurial. Journey, my entrepreneurial journey, and I wanted to have the two to be separate, because being an entrepreneur in itself is a whole different ballgame. It comes with its own struggles and its own stories. So I kind of wanted to be seen not only as a baker but also as a businesswoman and try and navigate through that that side of things. So I think I did a pretty good job. I had 3 speaking engagements where I shared stories. I did the one with She Was a Baker. I'll post the story, the thing on this video. Whatever, yeah, and you can watch it. She Was a Baker, she's from Namibia, and she became my friend. Oh, so I said, she was a girl. Yeah, and then I did the Lean in Circle virtual chat about imposter syndrome, because I did suffer from imposter syndrome and still do. But now that I know what it is, slowly navigating through that, helping me a lot. And then I did being a high value woman as well with the Lean in Circle. And I spoke on that and I shared a lot of me and my life in that part. So here's to more speaking engagements. 2021, I'm claiming it. Sharing my story and also just, oh no, wait, I also did the Bongo Hype web series about the business of baking. So I think I'll post the link here and you guys can click in and watch it. What else did I want to do? Instagram, I grew my following, made 3,000 family members on Instagram. Can you guys see this right? It says a new love life. Yes. Not so successful in that part, but anyway, we move. Guys, if anybody wants to propose to me in 2021, feel free. Now accepting applications. Now accepting applications for Mr. Stewart. If you want to be part of the family. What else is here? Personal wealth. I was a little late to the saving and investing party, but rather start than not. So I did start, and I'm just, I guess, something I still want to work on. And learning to let go. I still struggle with learning to let go. But I don't know. Learning to let go of things, people, situations. I think we all have to. Well, I'll speak for myself, but always easier said than done, isn't it? But 2020 taught me that no matter how much you want someone to stay, if they want to go, they will always go. And it just, it's about accepting in life that those who really want to stay will stay. You know, you don't have to make somebody stay, you don't have to force somebody to stay, you don't have to love somebody harder for them to stay. Because no matter how much love you want to give, you cannot love someone into loving you back. It just doesn't work like that. And that's a big, big lesson that I learned. Yeah. I'm good. I'm actually good, guys. I'm really good. So that's a recap of my vision board, and I'm gonna just I feel like I did quite a few of these. The only, I would have done more, just that I guess with COVID, a lot of things kind of shifted and changed. Another thing that we're gonna, that I'm gonna talk about is that I went back to work. I actually went back to work, like formal employment, because when COVID hit, things were pretty tough. You know, like events were canceled and weddings and birthdays and those, you know, functions and gatherings. So kind of took a hit on my business. And even though I'm still trying to navigate the new space and how to function in that space, I had to face reality and actually the job 9 to 5. But that didn't stop me. It took a lot for me to then like kind of juggle both being at work and being in business, you know. And at a point I developed a love-hate relationship with my business, because I don't know, that's another story for another day, but it just felt like a lot, like I couldn't keep up, like I wasn't able to match the energy that I used to, the effort that I used to. And I was kind of disappointed for some time, because I really, the only thing that I really wanted to do was just be in the kitchen. But life happens, and you know, God always knows what we need, even before we know that we need it. And so I did go back to work, and I love my job. I actually love my job. It's amazing. And what else happened? So yeah, I've been working for the whole year, still hustling, still doing my cakes and stuff. And I grew also in my career, though. I did. This is a big role that I'm in right now. I won't really say where, but it's a big role that I'm in. It's fun, lets me meet new people and other people, and to do what I love, which is creating. And also it just put me in the spotlight. I made the newspaper. And it has stretched me in terms of how I think, the ideas I produce, my execution on those ideas, and my interactions. I've done interviews. I've never interviewed anyone in my life, but I did an interview with the CEO of Liquid Telecom, and she was a lot. So yeah, I mean, all in all, that was the year that was, you know. It wasn't really like, I got to do this, I got to do that, you know. But I'm still pretty grateful for everything that happened and how it all played out. I hope for a better year, I think, in terms of just my business and my personal life. And another thing, I think this year was just showing up for my friends in the best way that I could, because there was a time when I really neglected my friends. I won't even lie, I did. But this year I made sure that I showed up for them. When they needed me, I was there. And however I could help, I tried my best to do that. And I don't have many friends, I've got a few. But the few that I have are so special to me. I love you guys so much, because even through the year and everything that happened, you guys held me down so much, and I'm so thankful for your friendship. I'm super, super thankful for your friendship and just the love that you've given me. And just, you know, I hope that I've given you that love back. But I want to post a scripture for you guys. If you haven't done a vision board, or if you're thinking of doing one, or even just writing down your goals and your dreams, I won't share mine for now, because obviously it's the beginning of the year. Some of these things are just left, you know, out of the eye. You never know who's watching, wondering, wishing that on you. So I'm gonna just do that and keep it aside. But yeah, if you wanna do that, you can always reach out, give me a call, holler, let me know if you want. I think I'm not a professional, but I can just give you some guidelines, I guess, from what I learned from the one I attended. And yeah, just, it's not even that deep. You just have to write what it is that you want to achieve, by when you want to achieve, and pray over it. Okay, have I left anything out? I made new friends. Okay. I made new friends, and I gained an old friend who came back into my life a few days ago. I'm pretty happy about that. my life kind of came, I won't say full circle, but there's a full circle moment that happened. And I'm sorry, I was going to tell you this video, but here we go. There was a time a few weeks ago after I had launched the Christmas collection. That was another highlight of 2020. We launched our first Oasis collection. It was bomb. So there was that. Anyway, moving forward. What do you want to say? Oh, so my mom asked me. She said, "Did you ever think that your business was going to get this far? You know, when you went to culinary school." So for those who don't know, I was baking for about 10 years, self-taught and everything, and then I went to culinary school for about a month, I came back, and then just, I wanted to get certified. So, she asked me and I was like, no, I didn't, because when I went to school, I did it because I wanted to do it. It was out of fun and just out of, it wasn't with the intention of I want to grow business. And then I look back on it and I laugh because when I finished high school, I actually did go to culinary school, for those who don't know. That would be another video for another day, guys. But I studied hotel management, which also includes like in the kitchen and stuff. I hated it. I hated every single second of wearing that uniform, of being in the kitchen, of just, like, I could not stand it. Which is so bad. But, I mean, that was me and that was then. But you see, God has this thing where, when he knows exactly where to place you, when to place you. And when we were doing the Christmas collection, like after I left, I dropped out. Like I got my certificate after a year and I dropped out. I was like, I can't do this. So I used to wear like the whole chef's uniform and everything, and I left it. I was like, Jack, ain't for me. What about my business? And a few weeks ago when we did the video shoot, the shoot for the Christmas collection, I suited up again. And I put on the chef's uniform and it just felt like a full circle moment, because when I put it on this time, it's like I fell in love with the idea of wearing it. And I think I fell in love with the idea of wearing it this time because I had appreciated the journey that led me to this moment. At that time, nothing had happened for me to want to wear it, you know, like I hadn't even found out what I wanted to do in my life or what passion I had. So it just felt like another thing I had to do, just wear the uniform. But every single moment, every step, that was in 2008 or 2009. 10 years. For me to come back and say that, you know what, there's no place I'd rather be than in this uniform. And I tell you, it was so funny. And I was like, Lord, you know exactly how to get me, you know. And I just wanted to share this story. But anyway, guys, you know what, I wish you nothing but the best for 2021. Hold your breath. When I know sometimes it feels like you're drowning, and I know sometimes it feels like no one will get it, and I know sometimes you want to quit and you want to give up, and there's days when you wake up and you're not even yourself, and there's days when you have anxiety and panic, you know, just washes over you. I know, and I can't tell you that get over it. I can't, because I know how hard it is to fight those feelings, the feelings of fear. But you know what? As long as you believe in you, as long as you know what you want to do, as long as you know that God has your back, as long as you know that everything will always work out in your favor, whether it's a year from now, 2 years from now, 10 years from now, everything will always work out in your favor. Commit your year to God, and just live. we spent this year just trying to survive. But I think for me, I forgot what it felt like to just live. I was so busy just existing that I didn't even know what it felt like to have a life. And now I do. And don't get so caught up in trying to make it. Take time for yourself. Rest. Recharge. You know, it's important. Everything. Taking time for yourself is just as important as working hard. Trust me. I love you. I just realized that this thing is so far away from me. I hope it has caught all the sound. I love you. And until next time, guys, please remember to keep it all so sweet. Have a happy, blessed, and prosperous 2021.